गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स इंग्लिश क्लास एंड आई एम कमलनाथ। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश। दिस वीक यू ऑल आर लर्निंग स्टोरी बेस्ड ऑन सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर, नाइट विचेस। दिस इज द सेकेंड वीडियो। इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो आई हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड दिस स्टोरी इन विच आई हैड इंट्रोड्यूस्ड यू अबाउट द वॉर, about the small plane Polycarpo PO2, and of course how the two fighters of Soviet Union no doubt just fought with the German fighters, and they were offered vodka when they came down, they landed in the field by the people, those who were watching near a Soviet junction. So they refused, as I had told you in the last video, first video, that these two pilots, those who were fighter pilots, refused to take vodka, that was alcohol. They thought that they were lads, means they were boys, they were men, but it was not so. Let us hear now, continue in the next part, that is second part, what happened. As they were thinking that the pilots were male, they were not male, it was Tamara Pamanirik. That was Tamara Pamanirik, one of the members of the, that was what, 588th Night Bomber Regiment. She was one of the members of 588 members were there in Night Bomber Regiment. They were also the members of that of the Soviet Air Forces. The 588th was the most highly decorated female unit in the force, flying 30,000 missions over the course of 4 years. It was a great record for these female fighters. Okay, they had the record of flying over 30,000 missions over the course of 4 years and dropping in total 23,000 tons of bombs on invading German armies. Its members who ranged in age were from 17 to 26, flew primarily at night only. These fighters primarily or mainly just flew their planes at night, and their age ranged only from 17 to 26 years only, making do with planes that were per their plywood and canvas construction, generally reserved for training and crop dusting. They were also flying the same planes as I had introduced you in the very first video, that was mainly made of plywood and canvas, and so it was no doubt neat, air thin and very weak. It was no doubt it had a flimsiness, generally reserved for training. These planes were generally reserved for giving the training for the recruits members, and that was used even for crop dusting. That you know very well what is crop dusting. That is where spraying powdered chemicals on crops from the air only to kill insects or help crops grow better. Okay, that is what crop dusting. From the sky only, through that planes, a kind of just powder was sprayed on the crops in the fields. That was your powdered chemicals, okay, to kill the insects or to help grow here the crops better. For that reason, that was what crop dusting. They often operated in stealth mode, silently, without making people know, idling their engines as they neared their targets. They didn't try to know the people know, the enemies know about their flight mode, and they were no doubt going very near to the targets, very near, and gliding their way to their bomb release points. without making them know where they had to drop the bomb, where they had to release the bombs. They were mainly carrying the bombs. As a result, their planes made little more than soft whooshing noises as they flew by. When they came very close to the target, their target at the place where they had to drop the bomb, they were making a sound, soft sound, that was whooshing noises as they flew. Let us hear, see what was the result of that. Those noises reminded the Germans apparently of the sound of a witch's broomstick. The sound that was made by that planes, fighter planes, when they came very low, at the low height, to release the bombs, to drop the bombs, they made the whooshing sound. And this sound made the Germans feel like the witch's broomstick. That was like a broomstick of the witches. So the Nazis began calling the female fighter pilots Nachthexen, that means night witches. That was the reason German people and soldiers started calling these female fighters of Soviet Union night witches. Very well, it is clear to you who gave them this here night witches title. They were the German soldiers. Those who gave this here name to the Soviet Union female fighters, this title, as the plane made whooshing sound, and that sound reminded the German soldiers like it was the sound of witch's broomstick. And due to that here, that sound, broomstick of witches, they started calling the female fighter of Soviet Union as night witches. They were loathed and they were feared. Any German pilot who donned a witch was automatically awarded an Iron Cross. That was a kind of medal, that a kind of reward that was given to that German fighter who killed any such female fighter of Soviet Union. They got the reward. If any German soldier killed the female fighter of Soviet Union, they called witches, they got award, and that was Iron Cross. That was the title given to German soldier. The night witches were largely unique among the female combatants. And what happened then? And even the female flyers of World War II. Other countries, the US among them, may have allowed women to fly as members of their early air forces. Those women, however, served largely in support and transport roles. These female fighters were mainly playing the roles of air transport, so transporting the equipment, air war equipment, weapons, bombs. Largely they were playing the role of the transport. The Soviet Union was the first nation to allow women, to fly combat mission, to be able essentially to return fire when it was delivered. These ladies flew planes, they also dropped bombs. They flew planes, and at the same time these ladies pilot, women fighters, dropped bombs as well from their planes. Last week, one of the most famous of the night witches, Nadezhda Popova, you could see the her pictures here in the picture, in the book only, book story. Nadezhda Popova, a commander of the squad who flew in total 852 of its missions, passed away. She was 91. At the age of 91, Nadezhda Popova died only, who flew in total 852 of its missions. And the obituaries. Obituaries means the news that comes about the death news only. That is called obituary. The column in the newspaper that here gives the report of the death of anybody, that is called obituaries. So, and the obituary that resulted celebrations of the title and a legacy largely unknown to many of us here in the US serve as a reminder of the great things the female flyers accomplished. And that was the column those who no doubt described about the female flyers and their just missions and their achievement. Things made even more remarkable considering the limited technology, and it was even a challenging task for the women fighters as the technology was very limited. They were not equipped with here good technology, high technology as today we have. Okay, that time the already plane that was sold, already sold, and I have displayed you on the screen, and you have in the book as well, in the page 68 you have seen Polycarpov PO2, how small it is, and it was made of plywood and canvas. It was already told it was not very weak, very weak, and they use the female fighters use these planes only to carry the bombs, to drop the bombs and complete their mission. So it was a challenging task for these women fighters. The witches, they took the German epithet as the badge of honor. No doubt these witches were as the badge, as the honor by the German soldiers. They gave the name, and as they called the witches, they were afraid. They were feared, they were afraid. And that's why this was as a title given to the female fighters of Soviet Union. The witches flew only in the dark because of the weight of the bomb they carried and the low altitudes at which they flew. They carried no parachutes. There were no parachutes as well. In any casualty, they will have a great problem. They had no radar to navigate, means to show them the way. Navigate is what a device that gave them the direction and the proper information in which direction they are going and where they have to go. There was no navigation system in their path through the night skies, only maps and compasses. If hit by tracer bullets, if that planes were hit by the tracer bullets, enemy bullets, their craft would ignite like the paper plane. It would have burnt like a paper plane they resembled, which was not a small concern. Almost every time, Popova once recalled, we had to sail through a wall of enemy fire. And Popova used to tell, she remembered her mission, and whatever the difficulties she faced, she made this recommend. We had a sail through a wall of enemy fire. Means it was a great really risk and a very dangerous really just mission they were just facing and they were just doing. So these were the part of today's video. I hope that you must have understood here this part, and I will have the last video that I will bring you just next time. So just wait for the third video. I'm sure that you will just go through whole story and this part of the video. Thank you, students. Thank you very much being with me. Thank you.